I command the Black Horse Troop, Company H, 4th Virginia Cavalry Reenactment Unit.
Left in the line, march!
The Black Horse was actually the Warrenton Mounted Militia. Started in 1859 as a mounted local militia unit, mounted because they could cover the county fairly quickly. And it was called the Black Horse because the members were generally the sons of wealthy plantation owners, lawyers, merchants. So the Black Horse chose to uniformly mount themselves on black horses. That's the Black Horse name. Then when Virginia seceded, the Warrenton Mounted Militia was inducted into the Confederate Army, specifically the Confederate Cavalry under Stuart, and was designated Company H of the 4th Virginia Cavalry.
I started doing this about 4 years ago, and I met my friend, and he was talking about Civil War reenacting, and I said, oh, I'd like to try that. So I met with the rest of the unit, and they gave you an interview, like, can you ride? Then I got some of my equipment, little by little, you get it. And with my first reenactment, I couldn't even get dressed. I had to come out, I'm like, they had to dress me. I was like, then the Civil War Barbie. Like, they were putting my suspenders on and, like, you know, help me with my belt. I was a mess, you know, the equipment's not easy, especially if you don't know what you're doing.
My husband started doing it, and the first reenactment we went to, I went to dress up as a woman. And he went on a tactical, which is basically like a non-scripted battle. They go out into the fields and they battle for up to four hours. So I'm out there, and she's got me on a shirt this high and a long, long dress, and they're gone for 3 hours. I'm like, what do? And she goes, well, we cook and we clean and we can mend socks. I said, so you're gonna work with no modern conveniences on the weekend? She said, well, we could cook their meals. And I said, well, I don't want to work that hard on the weekend. I know how to ride. So I looked around, I said, well, I've got my credit card and I've got the car keys. I said, where's them all? And she said, well, I don't know, because we're out in the middle of some farmer's field, you know, doing the reenactment. I said, well, and her son looks and he goes, well, that big tent over there, that's called the sutlers. I said, well, what are sutlers? She says, it's the closest thing to a mall you're gonna get, Lenny. So we walked over there and I bought my boots, used half price, and Alan came back, my husband came back. And he said, oh baby, I had the best time. We did this, we shot, we rode over fences, it was great. And I said, oh, that's nice. You know what I did? I cooked turkey burgers all day for 4 hours. I said, I'm riding next time.
I've been interested in horses all my life, actually. I'm a graduate of Virginia Tech with a major in animal science, and so I studied horses a little bit in college. Part of the thing about the hobby that appeals to me so much, not only do we get to ride, but the camaraderie with the group. We're like a small family. We work together, we travel together. We really practice our art to try to improve our impression, because that's an important thing for us.
My horse is Mysterious Lee. She's a 12-year-old Morgan. And I have to introduce her first because she's my number one weapon in this hobby. And she gets me through whatever we need to do. Started doing this about 3 or 4 years ago, and thought, you know, I didn't want to hold a pistol, I didn't want to hold a saber, and oh God love, you know, going into a battle with everybody. But through training with my captain and the rest of our unit, we do like every weekend if we can. So we do a lot of these, and she's phenomenal.
This is my horse. His name is Murphy. And his whole name is Murphy Platinum Edition. And he's a Tennessee walking horse. He's 20. And I just got him into reenacting about 3 or 4 years ago. And he's holding together pretty well. It's a little difficult for them, I think, when you start them at an older age. But he's a good boy.
This is Titan. Titan is about a 13-year-old Morgan. There you go, pretty man.
First and foremost, it's an opportunity to ride your horse in a venue totally different from anything you've ever done before. A whole new set of challenges for the rider, a whole new set of skills that the horse must learn. It's a lot of fun. So that's first and foremost, is we're a horse club, and we do this because we love riding. Secondly, we've chosen to use the Civil War as the venue, if you will, for practicing and improving our equestrian skills, and which is awful easy to do since we're right in the middle of Civil War history here in the state of Virginia, Northern Virginia, in this area.
The interest in the Civil War actually is, with me, is my great-grandfather was captured at Gettysburg, a prisoner of Fort Delaware. He was with the Jeb Stuart campaign, but he was with the McCausland Brigade out of West Virginia, the Wildcat Cavalry. And I just got really interested in it because my grandfather, my mother's father, was born in 1862. So the history is very close.
I know generations back I had great-great-great-grandfathers who were in the Civil War. I have a great-great-aunt who is now 104 years old, and she was a member of the United Daughters of Confederacy.
I went to Cedar Creek. That was like 10,000 reenactors. It was huge. He was scared to death. And I do remember sitting there waiting to go. It was kind of rainy. It's like mountain weather. And it was time to go. We were sitting there, and the bands were playing, and the music was playing, and we're sitting, the wind's blowing my hair, and I'm nervous because I don't know what he's going to do. And for just a millisecond, you were there.
At one point, we were in single file rank, and we were coming through the woods, and the trail kind of snaked through the woods and went up the hill, and I was about in the middle of the line, and so I could look up and see the line of soldiers up ahead of me, and I could look back and see the line of soldiers behind me, and you couldn't see anything of modern day civilization. And to just look at that and think, that's what they saw 150 years ago. That's an interesting feeling. Not everybody gets that.
For us, this is just an opportunity to get together, go on a long ride through some gorgeous horse country, step back 140 years to some degree, to the degree we can, and have a wonderful ride.